Hi, hello and welcome. This is your favorite chef Shribala. I hope you would love my recipes. Please like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel and click the bell icon to turn the notifications on. Enjoy and happy cooking.
A very, very happy new year to one and all. Let this new year bring a big, big happy news to every one of you, including me. Let's start it with a positive note. We are going to do a ghee rice called the Nechoru from the Malabar region. Come, let's see it.
Kindly make a note of the ingredients needed for Nechoru or the ghee rice. It's a very, very yummy recipe. In a pan, I'm going to add first a dollop of ghee and I'm adding cashew nuts. You need to roast it golden brown. Then I'm adding the raisins and you can remove it in few seconds. Set it aside. This is done now. In the same pan, I'm adding the sliced onions. The onions should be sliced very thin. Only then you will get a nice caramelized fried onions. This is very important. You also ensure that you don't overcook it. It will become very bitter. So you need to either deep fry it or saute it. I'm adding a pinch of sugar so that the caramelization happens nicely and a creamy texture happens also at the same time. So be very careful not to turn it bitter. Don't overcook it. Now, in a large vessel, I've added ghee, the balanced ghee. In that, I'm adding cinnamon, clove, cardamom, and bay leaf. We're keeping the flavors very, very subtle. Here again, I'm adding the onions. I'm crushing it so that the strands are visible completely. Saute it nicely. Add ginger garlic paste, make your own paste and use it. I've soaked the kaima rice. I've soaked it for 45 minutes. I'm adding a pinch of sugar in this, again for caramelization. Then I'm adding the salt. The more you soak the rice, you need to add very little of water while cooking. So half an hour to 45 minutes you can soak the rice. For one portion of rice, I'm using one portion of water. You can go as per the instructions given in the rice packet. Mix it nicely. After 10 minutes, you can see it's got a nice boil. This is the last 3 to 4 minutes. It's getting completely cooked. I'm not going to drain the excess water because I've added only one portion of water for one portion of rice. It's set now. So I'm going to add the fried cashew nuts, raisins, then the caramelized onions, that is the fried onions. I'm going to add some fine chopped coriander also. Drizzle it on top so that it absorbs the coriander flavor as well. An awesome Nechoru is done now. I'm going to close it for 5 minutes and leave it as it is so that all the flavors get released. Let's see after 5 minutes. It's completely set now. Let's plate it. A yummy nechoru is ready to be served. This can be served with mutton or chicken curries. For vegetarians, you can make an awesome protein-rich curries. I hope you would love this recipe and give me your feedback.